In this example, it is given that a swimmer wishes to cross a river flowing at 3 km per hour in minimum time. We are required to find the direction in which he should swim to achieve this if he can swim at 5 kph relative to water. Let's draw the physical situation here. So if this is the river, at one bank of river, if swimmer is there, he wants to reach the other bank of river in minimum time. We know very well that if width of river is d, the time to cross can be simply written as d divided by vc, where vc is the crossing velocity. If he jumps in any direction other than normal, the crossing velocity will be the component of that velocity in normal direction. So if we want to minimize this time, we need to maximize the velocity with which it will cross. So he must jump and head his swimming in the direction perpendicular to the bank, so that he will be heading towards the point B. However, due to addition of this flow velocity, he will be able to reach somewhere else. But in this situation, if velocity of swimmer is in the direction which is along the line AB, we can simply state this time to cross will be D by VS. In any other direction, if he would be swimming, then this time would become D upon VS cos theta, that will be more than this. So to minimize time, he must swim in the direction perpendicular to the river current. So we can simply state if time is minimum, we can simply state the direction in which he should swim in be perpendicular to current. You can also write down this as a note, a theoretical note which will help you in future for various questions. That is to minimize time to cross the river swimmer must swim in the direction perpendicular to river current. This is the answer to our question, as well as this particular result will be helping us in several such type of questions. So keep this result in your mind.